Welcome to Hands-On Repair. Today's video, I'm going to be looking at a RetroN 5 that I bought on eBay. The seller said that they plugged in a 12-volt power supply whenever this actually accepts 5. StatsticsFix, he did a series of really cool videos on the RetroN 5. I'm going to make sure to put those down in the description. Chances are you've probably already seen it, but he deserves credit. Puts out a lot of really great content, and you really should check him out. So I'm going to go ahead and plug it in. 100% sure this is not going to turn on, but I'm going to do it anyway. And it doesn't. So the question is, can it be repaired? Is cracker open? Let's find out. Okay, so we have it under the microscope, and right away we see that that component is toasty. That one is too. That does not look good. I believe that's a protection for the HDMI port so that you don't have voltage going into your TV or your tuner or whatever it might be. Okay, so first things first, I'm gonna go ahead and remove this component and this component, which are visibly not good. And then I'll test for shorts. Some isopropyl alcohol. right, so I'm gonna go ahead and put my multimeter in diode mode, and I'm gonna put red probe on ground. And let's see if there's any shorts. See if this one's bad or not. Good, good, good. When you hear a short beep like that, it's good. All right, so we have a short here, so this is gonna be bad too, I believe. And that goes straight here. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get this changed out. And we'll test again. Meter back in diode mode. Red probe on ground. Let's try again. Good. 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 Still a short. That is not good. Good. And that's still shorted. Let's test this up here. That still has a short. Wonder if it has something to do with that. So after doing a little bit of thinking, I may be getting a short down here because of this component that's blown up here. So I'm going to go ahead and pull this out and see if there's still a short down here. This into diode mode, my multimeter that is. Red probe on ground, fingers crossed. No. We're still short. Oh no. Okay, so I've plugged it in. Looks like something on the back of the board. That component's getting hot. And that one's getting hot. Let's get it under the microscope, remove that, and see if we get rid of some shorts. Good. That looks good. And that looks good. So I'm going to go ahead and get this cleaned up really quick, and then we'll see if those shorts are gone. In reality, I probably should have tested whenever I took the old one out. But to be honest with you, I completely forgot. So we're back on the top side of the board. I'm gonna go ahead and put my multimeter in diode mode. And we'll see if the short is gone. I'm hoping so. Good, 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 oh wait, good, good. That is a very good sign. Good and good. So I still have to replace this. I have the part number for that, but I'm gonna grab that from a donor board. So if you end up getting rid of all of the shorts and you find that you don't have any video, say the system turns on, but you don't have video output, double check on this component. I'm going to put it in the description or in the video itself, but I had another case where this was bad, and you can test this in diode mode. These should all get readings. This is ground, and these should get readings as well, but you should never get a short on any of these pins except for the ground, obviously. So if you do and it doesn't look bad, it's probably still bad anyways. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull that component and get it soldered onto this one, and then we'll be able to plug it in and see what happens. Good. Ground, that's good. Good. And good. I think I'm ready to plug it in and see if it works. Alright, so the moment of truth. Got it put back together. Don't need anything else hooked up to test it to see if it works. So I'm going to go ahead and plug in the HDMI. Without completely ruining it. Plug in the power. All right, here we go. Got a power light. Let's see if we get a picture. Saw a flash. Oh. Wow. It is looking like it's fixed. That's pretty awesome. Wow. Well, so that was pretty difficult. I ended up changing, what was it, like 5 components? That distribution chip, or the voltage chip, whatever it is, I'll let you know. Those 3 components that are normally bad from Statistics Fixes video. And that component, I think it's got little diodes in there. Basically, it stops the current from going into the input of your TV or tuner, because that would be very bad. That was also bad. But I'll make sure to put a list of all of the components in the video. Well, if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.